Hello, 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 and welcome back to Magic Show here at Showbiz Pizza Place. Now, this next song certainly conjures up a special feeling of magic in my heart. It's called Every Little Thing She Does Is Magic, and it's by a band I'm sure you're all familiar with called The Police.
Wait, Fats, wait, hold on. Before you play your next song, I wonder if you'd mind if I did a little segment of letters to Looney Bird.
Well, I don't know, Looney Bird. I like your show and everything. No offense, but I'm just about to sing a song, and I'd like to use these few minutes for my own little introduction, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So it's not often I get to visit with the audience here. I like to talk to them just a minute, you know?
Okay. Well, I'll be real quick. And besides, the next letter was written to you.
No, I said it's, what?
Yeah, to you.
it's written to me?
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you say so? That's a horse of a different color.
Yeah, okay. Well, thanks,
go right ahead and read it there. Yeah, take all the time you need.
See, Looney Bird, all you had to do is ask politely. A few good manners goes a long way.
Read the letter, Looney Bird.
Yeah, okay. Quiet on the set. Give me my music. And now, Showbiz Pizza Place proudly presents Letters to Looney Bird. An in-depth look at characters, places, and even some other characters here at Showbiz Pizza.
Read the letter, Looney Bird.
Your host today is me, Looney Bird, the world-renowned. Okay, I'll read the letter. Okay, forget the intro. Okay, here's the letter. This letter is written from 8-year-old Debbie Hawkins of Jacksonville, Florida. We got anybody from Jacksonville out there?
Read the letter, Looney Bird. I want to hear what you tell them.
Okay, yeah, quick, here it comes. Dear Looney Bird, I am writing you this letter because I have a crush on Fats.
Mm.
Yeah. But please don't tell him because I would just die. Could you find out how...
read it, Looney Bird.
Could you find out how old he is so I can know what the chances are of us going steady? I am only 8, but my daddy says I'm real mature for my age. Thank you very much, love, Debbie Hawkins. Well, Fats, do you have an answer for Debbie?
Will you go steady with me, Fats? I just love those big muscles and black hair.
Hey, Duke, would you quit that?
Come on, Duke. Hey, come on. Let's
cut the sarcasm back there if you don't mind. Now, what was that? What was that question, Looney Bird?
Debbie wants to know how old you are.
Oh, that's right. Let me see. How old I am? I don't know. 20, 30, 40. Beats me. I really don't know.
Come on.
Okay, well, come on. I mean, you know, be serious.
Okay. Just let me think here. Tell you the truth, I'm exactly likely presently in accounting for not more or less than 11 years of faithful guerrilla service to all ape kind.
11?
That means I'm 11, not a day older.
You expect my show to have any credibility telling someone you're 11?
I am 11. That's what I said. And,
Beach Bear, what were you going to say?
I was going to say, if we cut his leg in half, I think we could count the rings and really find out the whole answer.
No, I'm really...
That's a zinger.
Thanks.
I'm 11 in gorilla years.
Oh, gorilla years. Explain that, please.
Well, you've heard of dog years, haven't you?
Boy, I'm a good commentator.
Well, yeah, you are, Looney Bird. You're a good...
Do you think I'm going to get good ratings for this? Excuse me. Go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I think you're a commensoor, too.
Now, come on, let's... how old are you, Pats? Go ahead, tell us.
Well, I'm 11 in gorilla years. You've heard of dog years and everything. One people year is supposed to equal 7 dog years, right? Well, so you got dog years, you got gorilla years, you got mouse years, you got bear years, bird years. You got all kinds of years. You got groundhog years. You got green-spotted snapping turtle years. And you got Tasmanian leaf-eating albino pygmy gopher years, you know?
Tasmanian, what?
Well, that... Well, you got walrus years, and you got antelope years.
Wait a minute, Fats. That's enough. We all got the point.
No, you got horny toad years, and you got pregnant guppy years. And you know what else you got? You got Sam the Chowderhead years.
Sam the Chowderhead. What brought that up?
Yeah, and you also you got water buffalo, baby water buffalo years.
How do you know all this?
I just know that I know about baby buffaloes. I know they're all required to hibernate during the first month of every year for a couple of weeks, unless, of course, they have a note from their mamas.
A note from their mamas.
That's exactly right.
Well, how do you know that?
It's common sense.
Oh, well.
Didn't you take biology in high school?
Yeah, I did. Was I supposed to learn that?
Yeah, they're supposed to teach you that. Guess you know, but you don't remember.
Maybe I kind of remember. I made a C.
You don't know about what the baby water buffalo?
Well, it's a little bit of it. Let me think about that for a minute.
Let's move on to another letter.
No, Looney Bird, I think we were only allowed one letter here. I don't know.
Yeah, okay, I'd sure Fats wouldn't mind if I read some letters. There were a few addressed to me. A few girls want to know about me, or a few birds want to know about me.
I'm sure they all do about Looney Bird, but can the letter stuff right now. We got to sing a song.
I just thought of something about water buffaloes.
No,
I learned.
Would you just finish up? Why don't you talk about water buffaloes outside there, Billy Bob? Take it on out the back door there.
Okay, Billy Bob. Come on, you're spoiling my show here anyway. Okay, what are we going to do now, Fats?
Well, I'd like to dedicate this next song to little Debbie Hawkins, wherever she may be.
Jacksonville, Florida. I said that at the beginning.
Oh, I tried before to tell her.